everyone, Gardablaze here, and welcome back to more Let's Play The Legend of Zelda The Minish Cap. In the last episode, we went and we got the wonderful fire element all for us. Plus, we also upgraded our sword to the White Sword, which was formerly known as the Pokori Blade. And then we just kind of got rid of our Smith Sword, so yeah. Anyways, we got a shiny new sword, we've been exploring Castle Town, seeing what new stuff there might happen to be. Which, honestly, there isn't all that much, but there is this place. Let's see, is it open? Yes, indeed, it is open. This place here is run by someone who might look a bit Yeah, he does not look a bit mysterious, like I was about to say now. He looks a bit familiar, because he's the person who runs the Nintendo Gallery in the Wind Waker. Just yet another returning character. Anyways, he takes these mysterious shells that we've seen, and takes them in exchange for figurines. Have I got an offer to make you? What do you say to trading it for a chance at winning a figurine? Sure! Basically, how many shells you'd like to use in this drawing. Basically, the more shells you use, the more likely you are to win a figure you don't already have. However, when you have absolutely no figurines, just giving you him one shell has a 100% chance of getting something new. Okay, great. Now just pour the level on the figurine dispenser machine over there. Nope. There we go. Pour the level. We get a little egg that hatches into a figurine of... Oh hey! It's the king! King Dartis, huh? I like my name of King Robin better. Anyways, the King of Hyrule, reported to have been a fine swordsman. He appeared in the Pokori Festival tournament as a youth and fought to a draw with Smith. Quite interesting though, huh? Congratulations! I'll keep the figurine in the case on the left for you. You can see it anytime. Anyways, if you go back to him, let's see... Yes, I want to try another drawing. How many shells will you try for the drawing? Yes, sadly you had to go through this every single time. As you can see, one shell now is a 98% probability. Two shells is 99, and three shells is 100. So, at first you can pretty much just keep trading in one shell. But after a while, yeah, you're going to have to start trading in a lot more shells, because one shell is going to be like a 40% chance. Let's see, it's a blue shell, which means it's an NPC, and oh hey, it's a great fairy we haven't seen yet. Spoilers! The Great Butterfly Fairy of Minish Wood. She provides you with a larger wand, allowing you to carry more rupees with you. Thank you for telling us something that I was going to show the viewers later on, game. Thank you. Anyways... If I recall, the eggs come in different colors. Red eggs are enemies, blue eggs are NPCs, green eggs are characters like Link, and if the egg is golden, it's a boss. Yes, yes. Anyways, yes, there is the figurine case over... No! Check. As you can see, there's a lot of figurines. A lot of figurines. And you can't even get them all yet. Like, the game is smart enough to actually, like, keep, like, some bosses and the final boss unavailable as figurines until you get the, until you fight the boss, pretty much. Let's see anything else. What's going on? What is all this? I'm busy, don't you see that? Do not disturb my research. If you have no business, be gone. You hurt me. Oh, fine. Be rude. Anyways, let's see, we don't really have much left to do in, Hyrule Town at the very moment. So... Let's go onward to Hyrule Castle and try to find this elemental sanctuary, shall we? And now that we've cut to Hyrule Castle Gardens, we can pretty much just be like, hey, how's it going, people? Nope, talk to them. Sorry, but I can't let you pass. We've sealed the area off because of Vaati. Really? Sorry, but I can't let you... Okay, you said the same thing, don't you? Okay, there's a... No, let's see. There's a, According to the map, let's see, zoom in. Yeah, so I guess I can't get to that fountain I drained through the Kinstone last episode, can I? Not yet. Nope, not yet. Give it a bit of time and we'll be able to explore the rest of the castle gardens, but for now we can still only access the fairy side. Are you sure I look alright? I never know what to wear on two formal occasions. Ezlo, you're a hat. You can't really do much besides what you already wear. Being born at, I don't know. Just, you're good, Ezlo. You're good. Hey, what do you two have to say? A sanctuary? No, I think I'd have seen something like that in the castle. Let's see. The Minister's fairy tales mentioned a sanctuary, I think. Oh, well, that's helpful. Thank you. Okay, so we have to go find the king and the minister here through the beautiful Hyrule Castle. Let's see, that leads down to the basement. Ah, here's the throne room. Okay. This place should look familiar from, like, the first episode. Poor Princess Zelda's still here, frozen in stone. Even turned to stone by Vaati's curse, her eyes are filled with life. Hurry. Save her. Anyways, we have King Robin, as I like to call him. Oh, Link, you have returned. Welcome. Did you gather the elements? Well, I have two of them. That's 50% at least. What? A sanctuary, you say? Why, I've heard of no such thing in my castle. Let's see. He does want to fuse kinstones, though. Let's see. You want to fuse kinstones this tower time? Well, I see no harm in it. Let's see. Do I have it, please? Do it? Yes. Okay, good. You want... The king does fuse kinstones with you, and you want to fuse kinstones right now because, small spoiler, if you don't fuse kinstones with the king right now, you're not going to be able to do so for a very, very long time. And it drains the fountain right outside his castle. Wow. Well, there's another thing we can't get to quite yet. Okay, let's see. Yeah, just drain the other fountain. Wow. Ah, perfect fit. Mine, but that's nice. Good luck to you. Anyways, what's the minister have to say about the sanctuary? A sanctuary? You know, I do recall a story my grandmother once told me long ago. She said she saw a doorway appear in the palace courtyard as a child. If this door does indeed open only once a century, it may be open even now. As with the Pokori themselves, the door is visible only to the eyes of a child. We might have walked past it recently and never even known it was there. Let's see, the minister also wants to fuse skin stones. Let's see, please. Oh, shoot. No, I don't have it. Ah, shoot. The minister, like the king, will, yeah, if I don't find the kinstone soon, I'm not going to be able to fuse with him for, quite some time. Anyways, we have a hint to go look for the palace courtyard, which is accessible here via the basement of the castle. Let's see, excuse me. Let's see. There's a locked door over here that I just tried to flip. Whoops. Anyways, if we head over here, we reach the castle courtyard. And if we just head along here, we find this magical glowing door, which kind of looks obvious, like a magical glowing door. Kind of looks like an obvious magical glowing door. Yes, redundancy. Alright. Anyways, Link, look, see how that door glows, like I just pointed out? Could that be the door that leads to the sanctuary? Nobody in the castle seems able to see it but you and me. Let's go, quickly! Anyways, we enter here and we are indeed in the elemental sanctuary with the wonderful, nice-sounding music that usually plays when we get a element. Anyways, we continue along here and the door is locked behind us. But at the same time, we are in a very beautiful looking room. So this is the elemental sanctuary then. This is where we can infuse your blade with the power of the elements. Yes, there seems to be a pedestal for your sword right in the middle there. Very nice room. I don't know why I'm going off over here just to, besides look at the room, anyways. Move along here, let's not dawdle anymore. Let's go to the fairy center here. Drop my sword in this pedestal and infuse it with the power of earth and fire. And with this, our sword changes color to purple and then to red. The powers of the earth and fire elements have infused your blade. And suddenly a giant tablet appears. Let's see if I can't read that tablet for you. Fill your sword with power and walk over the glowing tile. Perhaps it refers to those flashing spots in the floor around you. Well, what are you waiting for? Try it, Link. So now, after finding out... I was about to. Jeez, fine. After finding out about the, we've seen these panels before, but we can finally see what they actually do. As we now have a green bar that fills up, we can step over these magical spots, which have a white glowing circle on them, and now, huzzah! Whoa, you just split in two! So this is the power of the white sword. I guess you can double yourself like that anytime you see those panels. Yes, that is a major mechanic of the Minish Cap now, along with being able to shrink down into the size of a Minish, whoops, wrong button, is once you fill up that green bar with your spin attack, you can simply step over a magical panel, create a duplicate of yourself, and push down on panel, or push down buttons. Push all to cancel out the clone, and also pretty much you can just keep the clone as long as you want until the magic ball pretty much empties. Once it empties, well, yeah, clone goes away. Obvious enough. And let's see, anything else? If the clone spins too long in a solid object, like if I made a clone and then had the clone walk through this kind of bush plant on a stone thing, or just this bush down here, the clone will disappear because it's going through something that you normally wouldn't be able to go through. So yeah, just the rules of cloning yourself, at least in this game. It is a pretty cool mechanic though, and allows us to go and reach a bunch of new places that we have not been able to reach before, including the path to the next dungeon of the game. So let's see, I'd like to be able to find that kinstone. Just kinstone of that variety before I move on to the next section. So, interesting. You're the last person I expected to find here. And just as I was wondering who could be behind this, I find my old master.
Oh, what?
This isn't good.
Vaati!
And, as always, you are dressed in the shabbiest of rags. My curses are not to be mocked. The one I cast on you is most powerful. No matter what power you wield, you will never be able to break it. You haven't changed in the slightest. I should never have created that cap. It only fueled your insane desires. Fool, I had that grant the wishes of its wearers a spectacular creation. Thanks to you, I have gone from being a meek, minuscule nothing to the greatest sorcerer alive. You cannot stop me now, and I have you to thank for it. Accept this small gesture of gratitude from me.
Wait, Vaati, wait!
After him! We're trapped! Okay, for this quick battle here, you want to go and most likely actually pull out your shield, because these guys, oh, you just want to go and, okay, got one of these down. These guys cannot be hurt by your sword if they are charging. Okay, that was actually easier than I was expecting. Anyways, we're free. Yeah, they can block your sword with their sword, so yeah, guess it's simple enough.
That foul Vaati, what could he be scheming now?
Link, I feel I owe you an explanation of what has happened. You see, Vaati and I are both Minish. I was once a famous sage and a renowned Minish craftsman. Vaati was only a boy when I took him on as my apprentice, but he became enchanted by the wickedness in the hearts of men. One day, Vaati took a hat I made for the humans, my pride and joy. It granted the wishes of its wearer. He put it on without permission.
Thank you.
You know, the legends, of course. The gifts the Pokori give to the humans. What you call the Pokori Blade was the first of those gifts. The second, well, you call it the Light Force, but it is a source of limitless magical power. If Vaati were to get it now, it would be devastating. I came to the world of men hoping to stop Vaati, and I met you in the woods. But it seems we won't be breaking the curse on me any time soon. However, with the Sacred Blade, we can certainly restore Princess Zelda. I'm sorry. All that has happened has been due to my own pride, my folly. I must rely on you, on your power, until we put an end to Vaati. Well, Link, enough fairy tales. We must search for the next elements. And with that important piece of story, we now know the truth behind Vaati and Ezlo. And that Vaati used to be a Minish along with Ezlo, and well, as the title of the game states, the Minish Cap, it is either referring to the cap made by the Minish that Vaati now wears, or the fact that Ezlo, a Minish, was turned into a cap. Your choice as to which one's the true interpretation. Anyways, let's see, I do believe we opened this place up, so what have we unlocked? Ooh, a fairy fountain! Cool. Heal me! Okay, so we've unlocked a fairy fountain through a kinstone. And I'm just going to cut ahead to whenever I find a kinstone that the minister will take for fusing. And then I guess I'll just end the episode on that. Seeing as we've covered a lot of plot in this episode. Okay. It took like 10 minutes to find the freaking kinstones. But I think I got the one he's looking for, finally. Yes, yes I did. I got two of them. Okay, let's fuse the two kinstone pieces and see what we get. Please do not be in an area I cannot access yet. It's in an area... Wait, no, is it? That's Minish Woods. Where in Minish Woods did the treasure chest spawn? Oh, I can get them. Okay, that's fine. Sweet. They fit perfectly. I didn't expect that. Maybe something good will happen now. See where I speak to the normally. Oh, the door was indeed in the garden. My grandmother was right. Well, my family has always been known for its honesty above all else. But I still can't understand. Why is it that children can see the Pokori and the door, but I cannot? That is a good question. The door to the elemental sanctuary is in the castle courtyard? All we adults see is just another ordinary wall. Incredible. Please, just gather the remaining two elements and repair the sacred sword. I'm counting on you, Link. Never forget that. Anyways, I do believe that is good enough for the episode, so this is God Ablaze, and I will see you next time. So long, everyone.